Hey guys, and welcome back to The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time 3D. In this episode, we're going to be taking on the second temple as Young Link, and that is... I would give you guys the title, but I don't want to spoil it yet. I mean, it should be obvious already, but I'm kind of waiting until we explode this wall so we can get a better view at it, and that is Dagongo's Cavern. So... yeah, this is it. This is where we're supposed to kill off the baddies so the Gorons can come here and continue their harvest for bombs and such, because apparently they eat bombs. And then we'll end up getting ourselves the Goron's Ruby, because we need that, and that is actually the second spiritual stone that we need to get. So, I mean, we know what we're supposed to do, and I don't have to explain this. Let's just go in and get started. We're in a freaking fiery place, and it's all filled with lava and such, and... I'm excited. I love the music that plays here. It's not really music, it's just eerie sound effects, and I don't know, for some reason I just got really used to this, and it just sounds really nice. Like, I like it a lot, even though a lot of people might disagree. And hey, what's up, Gossip Stone? What time is it? What's cooking? Alright, it's 7:46 in the morning? Wow, I woke up early. I'm pretty proud of myself, but, anyways, let's go ahead and grab this bomb over here and throw it on this wall. This kind of introduces you to the whole, destroy cracked walls thing, because you're going to be using this quite a lot throughout the game. It's an endless feature. But here we have some baby Dagongos. What you want to do is wait for one to come near you, and then, you want to wait for one to come out of the ground and come near you. So, hello, little critter, please come here. And you want to hit it and have it explode near this cracked wall, because if you couldn't tell, yes, it will explode with you. Now, you could come back later on until you have an item that will allow you to dispose of this wall a lot easier instead of luring an enemy to it, but I don't know, it's just a lot easier, and that way I don't forget about this gold sculpula that you can easily pick up within this room. So, yeah, it's a pretty interesting tactic. It's not that, smart or crafty, if you think so, because I don't know, I don't really think it's that special, but I mean, it's something convenient, so why not use it to our advantage? Because when you do kill them, they explode with their corpse instead of just dying. Or, well, actually, what happens when you kill a Zelda enemy? I think, yeah, they just like disappear, so they don't do that, they explode, which is nice. But here we had some Armos statues. I pushed one on this switch. It has to be pressed in and must stay pressed in for this door to open. That's why I had to actually keep the Armos weighing it down. And by doing so, I was able to advance. Easy stuff. You know, we're in the second temple. It's not even a temple, as you heard me say in the beginning of this episode. The second temple as Young Link. So, it means it's like a prologue almost to the actual temples within the game. And if you haven't played this game, then don't worry. I'm not going to spoil it, but it should be obvious. Maybe. I don't know. I guess I just expect everybody to know this game almost as well as I do, because I've played it growing up, and it just, you know, seems like a staple in everybody's life. Oh, I've played Ocarina of Time. And if you haven't, then, you know, you're weird, but not really. I don't judge. Funny, because Ocarina of Time is, like, I believe the most notorious Zelda game. Anyone who has played Zelda, usually they say they have played Ocarina of Time, even though they might call Link Zelda. I had that in school all the time. Like, I had this awesome Twilight Princess shirt I would wear. Also, we killed some of those Ulfos, and that opened up a door, and we can advance. I mean, yada yada. You guys can tell what's going on. But, yeah, I had this awesome Twilight Princess shirt I would wear in, like, high school, and a lot of people would point it out. I would be like, oh, that's a cool Zelda shirt. Like, yeah, it is. You know what game this is? Like, no, but I played the one for the N64, and Zelda was awesome, and I'm like, yeah, and they'd, like, literally point at it, like, as in Zelda was Link, and that, I don't know, that should upset me. I know a lot of people do that who don't know the game that well, but seriously, why would you, I guess I always understood that as well, that people can assume that Link is Zelda because it's called The Legend of Zelda, and you play as... No, because it's freaking... I don't know, man. I can't, honestly. I disagree. Anyone who calls Link Zelda is dumb, because Zelda's a girl's name. Oh, man! Okay, so I killed a Dagongo here, and... I apologize to all the people who called Link Zelda. You're not actually dumb, but I killed one. They exploded just like the baby ones. In this room, while I was talking about shirts and whatnot, there is a Deku merchant that sells Deku sticks if you don't have any, because you're going to need some for this room. So yeah, and here we have some Dagongos just moving around doing their own thing. You want to do a jump attack, hit them on their tails, that will instantly kill them, because the jump attack does double the damage as a normal sword slice. And yeah, that's pretty much all there is to that, but let's go ahead and quickly light these torches as fast as we possibly can before any of them go out. And now we can advance throughout the temple. So yay, we're doing some progress, not bad. Anyways, wait a second, we're back into this room. I guess we haven't done any progress, man. No, it actually opens up the door to the other side, and that's why I completely ignored that side, because we were gonna come back to it once we have opened up stuff to it. But let's quickly jump before this platform goes down. We're gonna head inside that door we just opened up in just a second. First off, I just need to open up that wall, because I believe this will actually give us the dungeon map, if my memory serves me correctly. Is it so? And, well, yes it is. All right, sweet. Now we have the dungeon map and we can see the map a whole lot better instead of having it only appear on areas we have discovered. Regardless, maps aren't that important. I just still love the way it looks on the bottom screen, so I don't care. Here we have another Deku merchant who will sell us crap. I believe he sells you maybe the Deku Shield if you haven't burnt. I'm not too sure. I don't want to bother with him, because it's not like I, you know, really purchased anything from the other Deku merchant, so we're just going to leave him. But the only way to talk to them is by blocking with your Deku Shield. So actually, I don't think he'd sell you a Deku Shield, because that wouldn't make any sense, because you can't block with your Hylian Shield. So yeah. Anyways, place a bomb in the center of these row of bomb plants, and you shall create yourself stairs to head up. Now, I believe we can actually net ourselves the compass real quickly, which I do want to obtain by exploding this wall. So I'm gonna do that real quick. As I wait, we'll go ahead and do a quick dance. Check this out. Oh yeah, I can dance around by ducking with my shield, and it's really cool, and yeah, it's my whole song. Alright, well, go ahead and activate this guy to start targeting me. Hey buddy, take this bomb. Oh, okay, well, looks like you don't really like bombs. Ah, it hit him! Wow, how convenient. Let's see if this one will hit him too. And it did. It exploded with his explosion. But that Armos was trying to attack me. You need to hit him with a bomb, or I believe maybe on the back, and it will end up having him explode. And that was the only Armos within the room. That's why when we killed him, it opened up the door, because we would have been locked in here if we didn't kill all of the enemies within this room. The other ones were just Armos statues, so that was good. But yeah, we got ourselves the compass, and let's go ahead and keep going throughout this temple. Do some backflips instead of climbing these stairs, because it's a lot more time-consuming having Link grab onto the stair, put one knee up, and then his rest of his body up. You can just do easy backflips, and it will do the job just fine. But here we had a freaking Skulltula and a Gold Skulltula. As you can tell, Gold Skulltulas are a lot tougher. I believe they have much tougher skin, because, you know, it took two hits with the Deku Nut. Not Deku Nut. The slingshot to kill him, and the actual Skulltula, which looks like has like a skull face, took one, which is kind of weird, because you think they would have the harder shell on the outside. I mean, you can't even pierce through the ones that come down with their web with any item. You have to hit them from the back, and then with the other Skulltulas, it's completely different. It's like, if they're on the wall, you can hit them with any kind of item and they instantly die. Like, the head of them isn't as hard, it's a lot more soft. But they look exactly the same. It's just a big Skulltula and a Skulltula. That's the difference between them. And yeah, I never understood that, and I still don't, because it feels weird to kill a Skulltula that's like on the wall with a simple slingshot shot. But am I overthinking this? You know what? I might be. But anyways, you never know what will be around the corner in these narrow paths. Huh. What is it? Oh, no, it's a blade trap, and if it hits you, it knocks you back. How horrible, man. Well, we easily avoided that one, and whoops, I think I pushed this block too far back. There we go. We can easily pick up a nice heart, and then jump up here. Let's go ahead and make our way all the way up here, and actually open up this chest, because I'm a little curious of what's inside of it. Ooh, not bad. And I believe this is another chest that we can get. Can we? No, I don't think we can yet, so don't worry. I was deceived by the way the map was showing me another chest. Now I'm just like, can we get it now? No, we can. Regardless, stand over here, pick up this bomb, plant, throw it, and, oh, it actually landed on the ledge. If it doesn't land on the ledge, you just kind of want to wait right before it explodes and have it explode in midair, really, up to your timing. But I was lucky enough to have it land on the ledge and then explode at the cracked wall. And by doing that, I was able to advance, and oh no, baby Dagongos, let's just roll around them because I don't want to mess with them. They're terrifying. And here is another small mini-boss room with some Lasulfos. Oh man, am I excited to fight these guys. I hate fighting these guys because you're forced to wait. See, he's going to run away, and if I run to this one, he will run away from me until he's like, no, okay, I'm going to fight you, so why not I jump to your platform? You can't jump to mine. We're like just uninvited to fight these guys. It makes no sense, but I mean, you just gotta play by the rules, I guess. Okay, don't run away. Oh, also, he's invulnerable to attacks if he's not fighting you. He has to fight you. So, does that make any sense? No, I don't understand this double Lasulfo battle. Also, how does he hurt me? I'm like blocking his attack. Somehow he pierces through my shield. I think I'm just angled incorrectly to where he can actually hit me. I mean, this may look tempting, and you might not want to do it if you don't think you can walk past a really thin walkway. It's not even that thin, so never mind. I was being sarcastic. So, yeah. But you'll end up falling down, and you'll have to backtrack all the way back up here. So, I don't think you want that to happen. Anyways, in this room, we got ourselves another eye. Just hit it with your slingshot. And then quickly hit the one that's over here because these rings of fire only disappear temporarily, so you just want to quickly pass. You can't hear a timer, but it is ticking, so just keep that in mind. Anyways, up here, we'll be able to get ourselves the item of the dungeon, and that is going to be, if it isn't obvious by now, bombs. Yes, it's a bomb bag. Now we can hold up to 20 bombs. That is actually awesome. Now, let's go ahead and quickly jump down here and take out our lovely bombs. I don't think anything important is actually in here, but I'm gonna go ahead and explode it because why the heck not? Actually see what's inside this room. So, hello room. You got two Deku merchants. Was it even worth checking? No, it was not at all. Wow. Why'd I do that? Now I have to backtrack all the way up there. I am absolutely stupid when you think about it, because I'm pretty sure I just forced myself to backtrack all the way here. What the heck? Well, I guess I shall... Oops, okay, I'm not going the right way, am I? Oh, I gotta stop getting hit by that as well. This is definitely awkward. Let's go ahead and jump up here. And start making our way all the way back to where we picked up the bombs. But I'm trying to look around, just making sure I... You know what, we'll just avoid it. It doesn't really matter. I'm not too worried about that. But yeah, I'll make my way back to where that chest of the bomb bag was. And hopefully we'll be able to progress. Because, like an idiot, I fell to purchase things from merchants. And I didn't need any of it. So, whoops. Okay, we are back. It did not really take that long. I guess without the Lasulfo battle, it only takes you a couple seconds. But it wouldn't have mattered if I jumped down there if I had the switch pressed in. That's the whole point of making it all the way to here. But yeah, I don't know. I was just too stupid to realize. But giant dead Dagongo, when it sees red, a new way to go will be open. This is a really important tip for you all, and the reason why it's really important is because you actually want to drop bombs down here into the eye, the giant skull of this Dagongo that's in the center of the dungeon. Just go ahead and drop some bombs into both of the eyes and they will both light, and just like the tombstone said, a new way will open up. Just like that. So yeah, also we have a platform that's moving all the way up there. so we can easily take it all the way up here. But what I want to do is I want to go ahead and pick up this chest that has been avoiding me so much. Not avoiding me, because, I mean, technically, I could have just walked to it and picked it up. But it was annoying because I, for some reason, thought I was going to skip. And I'm like, I don't want to skip a chest. I want to pick it up and see what's inside of it. May have been almost nothing, but we picked it up, so I'm happy. Anyways, we are at the final section of the dungeon, just right over here. Is where the boss lies, but it is blocked. So what are we supposed to do? Well, go ahead and make your way over here. You can actually see on the map that there is a skull, signifying that the boss is actually there. And just ignore this whole room. It's supposed to be confusing in some sort of way, but it's not. I actually don't think it's supposed to be confusing. I think I'm just stupid and I'm assuming it is. But once you explode this cracked wall, we'll be able to pick up the final gold skull that we can currently get within this temple. It's right behind this Armos, so I want to quickly grab it. And then, do I even have to, is the door unlocked? Yes, it is. Okay, you know, screw you, man. I don't even want to bother fighting you. Just like, do I have to even waste my time? I don't, so why would I? Anyways, head your way up here. Oh, shoot. Okay, so fire keys do a full heart instead of like half a heart, which is scary because I hate them. But I believe there's a fairy right here. Yes. She's gonna have it heal me because I don't really want to catch it in a bottle. Too lazy. Anyways, we are back into this room, which we first started in once we entered the giant skull Dagongo's mouth. And this is all we need to do. The reason why we took that whole walk all around is to actually push down this giant block. You're supposed to push it in the center. Hello there, just die. Don't mess with me right now. I'm not in the mood. Oh, okay, another one. Hey, I just killed your brother. Now it's time for you to die. Thanks. All right. Actually, I want to pick this up, so. 5? I was hoping it'd be 10, not 5. That's like barely anything, but guys, once we do push this block into here, we can enter the boss door of Dagongo's Cavern. So in the next episode, we're going to take on the boss of Dagongo's Cavern.